quickly set the flaps for departure. Fuel set. A very quick configuration of the aircraft there for this departure. So let's get departure clearance and let's try again. Okay, attempt number two.
Land, runway 23 left. Clear for takeoff, runway 23 left, Eurowings 4235. Cleared to land, runway 23 left, Lufthansa 75.
So this time out, I wasn't overly enthused with how the plane went into a nose-up attitude, so I'm going to manually fly the departure until we're at a comfortable speed so that I can then allow the plane's autopilot to climb. Okay, so away we go for the second attempt. Drifting off the centre line a little bit. Bit of rudder to try and keep us straight. V1. Rotate. V2. Gear up, positive rate. This time, like I say, I'm going to manually fly the aircraft for a little while. We put the speed hold in, that's fine. Okay, so we'll put the autopilot in there. The aircraft does seem to have settled a little. Here's the nose up attitude. It was quite concerning. Again, we're starting to bleed speed off again, and that's
keeping an eye here.
Okay, so speed is dropping off again, so put the nose down a touch.
Eurowings 4235, did you copy? Turn right heading 310, Eurowings 4235.
So still having some problems. So having just experimented a little bit with manually flying the plane there through that turn.
Eurowings 4235, turn left at heading 280, proceed on course. Turn left at heading 280, resume on navigation. Eurowings 4235.
Yeah, with the it's going to take us an age to get there at this rate, but okay. Yeah. So as I was saying, having just gone through how the aeroplane was handling on the departure there, like the same as the first one where we crashed almost immediately after stalling, this aircraft just doesn't seem to have any power, so obviously it's an issue with this particular aircraft in the simulator. I mean, the plane is okay now, but it seems to me that there was a problem with it being severely underpowered at takeoff power. When you put the auto throttle in, it wants to come back to where it is now, which is sort of half engine power, which is nowhere near good enough for the climb. So from my perspective, I'm pretty convinced that there's a problem with this aircraft itself, that there's a setting somewhere that's not quite right, that it won't maintain high power. See now if we increase our vertical speed to see, because we've settled at 250 knots. Obviously, if we increase the rate of ascent now, we would need an increase in thrust to accommodate. That seems to be happening at the moment, so something with takeoff power, definitely. In any case, if we can't get the aircraft up to a cruising speed, then it's going to take an age for us to actually get over the North Sea and into British airspace, that's for sure.
Level 370.
climb and maintain flight level 370, KLM 1373.
Amsterdam Center, Delta 15 Heavy, with you.
Delta 15 Heavy, Amsterdam Center, roger.
Okay, so just to update then, what I've had to do over the last couple of minutes, we have now got a decent vertical speed of 2,000 feet a minute. Disengage the auto throttle again, and manually move the throttles forward, which has now got us up to 2,000 feet But it just seems to be whenever I put the auto throttle in that it just wants to halve the engine power, and obviously in the climb that's not much use to us. But we now have a standard rate of climb, and we are at the speed that I would have wanted us to be at anyway, even with the auto throttle working. So what we'll do at this point is we'll prepare the aircraft now for our arrival into Birmingham. It won't be long before we fly out over the North Sea. We're coming over East Anglia, just north of the Thames estuary, and then head inland towards Birmingham. Now, Birmingham Airport's two runways, 15 and 33, both have the same frequency for the ILS, which is 110.10. So, on the basis that we already know, regardless of what runway we are assigned, the ILS frequency will be the same. We can actually enter that into the system now. So that's entered in, ready for us for when we get closer and we are assigned our arrival runway. We're currently climbing to 20,000 feet. We were looking for 28,000 feet. We will make it to 28,000 feet as well. I'm just going to attempt the auto throttle again because we are now moving quite a way above our speed. So I'd expect the aircraft to throttle back.
Expect vectors visual.
runway 18 left, approaches 501, turn right, heading 265, proceed on course. Transavia 582, turn right, heading 020, send and maintain right level 300. Eurowings 435, climb and maintain flight level 280.
Climb and maintain flight level 280.
So we'll climb to our cruising altitude now. The test is going to be to see, because we put the auto throttle back in, to see whether it holds. See whether it holds that speed as we now climb up to cruising altitude. So ahead of the aircraft you can now see the coastline and the North Sea. It's a relatively short distance flying wise over the North Sea between the Netherlands, which we are currently over, and the UK. By boat takes ages, by plane really not that long at all, 20 minutes maximum. Yeah, and here's the problem again. We have the auto throttle commanding now. It should be maintaining 320 knots. It's not. It's losing speed again. So we'll take the auto throttle out and we'll go. We'll put the plane into a high level of thrust. So basically for departing and climbing in this particular A319 model, it would appear that the thrust needs to be kept manual. And even then the aircraft isn't behaving really as I would expect. In the climb here, just over 24,000 feet, 24,300 feet. It's still sluggish and still wanting to lose speed, so.
Portugal 604.
1927 is climbing to 8,300 for 13,000. ALM 1927, Amsterdam Center, Roger, QNH1015.
Ascend and maintain flight level 240, 8543.
ALM 1224, turn right heading 015. Air Portugal 604, turn right heading 075.
Turn right heading 075, Air Portugal 604.
ALM 1224, turn right heading 015. Send and maintain flight level 190. Air Portugal 604, contact approach 123.575. Turn right heading 015, send and maintain flight level 190, ALM 1224.
Point 123.575, Air Portugal 604. Amsterdam Center, Air Portugal 604, with you 11,000.
Air Portugal 604, Amsterdam Center, Roger, UNH 1016. Air Portugal 604, descend and maintain 3,000.
Descend and maintain 3,000, Air Portugal 604.
Air Portugal 604, contact approach 123.575.
Point 123.575, Air Portugal 604.
So from power issues in the climb, now we're at the cruise, the aircraft is really going for it, so we will put the auto throttle back in and just see what happens, see whether it'll hold in the cruise, 320 that we want, or whether we lose power again. be interesting to see. We're now out over the North Sea anyway, as I'm sure you're aware. You can see out from the picture. About 9 minutes crossing. And then I expect that shortly thereafter we'll get our instructions to begin our descent into Birmingham.
Maintain 14,000. 9773.
Lufthansa 4751. Climb and maintain flight level 370.
Climb and maintain flight level 370. Lufthansa 4751.
Lufthansa 416 heavy. Traffic is 12 o'clock, 4 miles at flight level 330. Boeing 777, report them in sight. 100, turn right heading 165. Climb and maintain flight level 350.
So that's the leg over the North Sea done. We're just coming over the east coast of the UK, just north of the Thames estuary, which is just down there. The mouth of the River Thames, which then runs through central London, famously, as most people would know. London is down in the distance over there. So a slight right turn. Just to start putting us in the general direction of Birmingham as opposed to just the United Kingdom. I expect in the next 5 minutes or so we'll start our initial descent for Birmingham.
right, heading 115716.
Okay, so that's our initial descent clearance down to 220. So we'll commence that descent. So hopefully before too long as well, we'll be able to determine, or we'll be told, what arrival will be making, be it a 3-3 or 1-5 approach. A 3-3 approach at this point would be preferential. It is we're south of Birmingham Airport, and 3-3 is the north is the northerly runway, so it would make sense from our position for a 3-3 approach, but 1-5 approach would mean that we'd just fly a right-hand circuit of the airfield.
Traffic is 2 o'clock, 4 miles, at flight level 300, Fokker.
So a 1-5 approach, so we'll do a right-hand circuit of the airfield, a 1-5 approach, southerly approach. It's no great shakes, it adds about 10 minutes to the flying time, but it's nothing dramatic. What it does mean is on departure back to Dusseldorf, we'll be able to depart straight out and head, essentially with a slight left-hand turn, head straight for the North Sea again. So the routing back will be quite a bit quicker. The aircraft is now configured to pick up the ILS track for Birmingham because we are flying by heading and not flying by navigation, by inertial navigation. We can set the airplane up to intercept the ILS, which I already have done. So a further descent now down to 14,000. Begin to slow the aircraft as well, just makes things a little easier for us. So generally for a 1-5 approach into Birmingham, our routing on a right hand circuit of the field takes us only just saw it. Right hand circuit of Birmingham for a 1-5 approach generally takes us pretty much over East Midlands Airport, turning left over East Midlands Airport to intercept the ILS for runway 15 at Birmingham, and then a further left turn onto the ILS track itself.
Please expedite your climb to flight level 2.
8-0.
Okay, so we've got clearance now for descent down to 4,000. So we need to start making our slowing manoeuvres at this point as well. So we're basically level with Birmingham Airport to our left hand side. A little bit of turbulence here as well. Just have a look to the left. It's too cloudy for us to be able to see Birmingham Airport, but we are to the right hand side of it right now.
134.175 for Eurowing 4235. East Midlands approach, Eurowing 4235.
Just passing East Midlands Airport. Cloud in the way at the moment, so you'll see it below the aircraft shortly. visible below those clouds. Yeah, it's just below the aircraft now. Below the tail of the aircraft, that's East Midlands Airport there, so 285. Bit of wing flex going on there as well. Some more slowing actions now. Bring the speed down to 195 because we are moving to intercept the glide slope for our approach onto runway 15 at Birmingham. We're still a little bit too fast to start putting in the flaps at the moment, so we're copping a bit of turbulence as well. Let's just make this turn. See, with some of the turbulence that we're getting, the wing flex should be pretty pronounced. The wing flexing up and down quite clearly. So we'll start to bring the speed down now. We're already putting the first phases of flaps in. We're closing in on intercepting the glide path now as well. We've just entered Birmingham Airport's terminal area. That's our instruction to intercept the glide slope. We'll contact the Birmingham Tower.
Tower, Eurowings 4235 is 20 miles north, inbound ILS, runway 15, approach. Eurowings 4235, Birmingham Tower, fly straight in, runway 15, UNH 1009. Make straight in, runway 15, Eurowings 4235.
So the autopilot intercepts the ILS and glide slope, and will now line us up with runway 15. We're still a good 20 miles out at this point. Okay, so the aircraft has established itself bang on the centre line. Although we're still easily about 14-15 miles off the threshold of 15 at the moment. Doesn't appear to be anything in front of us, which means we don't have the risk of a go around or missed approach. Well, we have a risk of a missed approach, obviously anything can go wrong at this point in a landing, but a go around because of other traffic is pretty much ruled out at this point. Just at this point to apologise if the picture's stuttering for you. I'm currently dropping frames because of my network. I'm not sure what's going on. Sort of the speed's bouncing up and down like there's no tomorrow, so there must be some form of a network problem at my end, so apologies for that. Okay, so the runway is now in sight. So we'll drop the gear and head to full flaps and slow the plane for landing. At the moment we are looking very, very good on this approach. Okay, continuing to look very good on the approach.
Ooh, don't sink.
Bit of wind shear.
Don't sink. 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 Don't sink.
Still being don't affected sink. By wind shear here, but don't sink. We should be okay.
Don't sink.
Disconnect the auto don't throttle.
Don't sink. Don't sink. Don't sink.
And there we have it, arrival into Birmingham. We'll have to quickly see where they want us to park.
Birmingham ground, Eurowings 4235, request taxi to the gate. Charlie, taxi to gate 74, via taxiway Charlie, Delta Victor. Taxiing to gate 74, via taxiway Charlie, Delta.
And we're on the remote stands, gate 73. Gate 74 is where I normally park, to be fair. And there we have it. So parking brake set. We will cut the engines. And open the doors and the hold. Okay, quite away from the stop mark. I'm used to slightly longer, larger aircraft than that. But there we are. Arrival into Birmingham. Okay, I'm going to take a quick breather there, then make a brew, and then we'll prepare the aircraft for the return flight back to Dusseldorf. Back in a few moments.